Hello everyone, welcome to the stream. Welcome to my stream about AmigaOS. And today we didn't start with music because something weird is going on with my emulated Amiga. And I'm trying to figure out what the problem is. Welcome SLT Snake, welcome to the stream. I hope you hear me well. Let me see if the problem remains. As you may know, my name is George Canos, and you can find me in various forums as Walkero. And the stream today, as every Friday, is about AmigaOS, AmigaOS 3.2, where we see we learn about the AmigaOS and we see various things around it and applications, and we see how we can install things on our operating system, so to make it more usable and for everyday use. Today I plan to discuss with you and see the, I don't know if you remember from last week stream, there was an error, there was a problem with an application that I showed you, and that was the Xbench. So during the week I tried to make it work. I discussed that with the developer of the application, and I'm actually found that there is a compatibility issue, which I'm going to show you why this didn't work and how this can be resolved. And as the developer assured me, he is going to release a fixed version that will support completely AmigaOS 3.2. But until then, I'm going to show you a way to make it work on AmigaOS 3.2 and show you how it works for your system and how you can use it for WHD load games. After that, we are going to see a few other utilities that I have in mind that would make the operating system more full and can be more useful, especially when you have to deal with archives. And we will try to bring things from AmigaOS 3.9 to AmigaOS 3.2 and see how we can make them work, like UnArc and AmiDock, how they can work on AmigaOS 3.2, and if there are any problems, how we can make it, how can we identify them and fix them. But give me a few seconds to have one more goal for IMP, because for some reason today is not working. And that's why I didn't have any music at the start of the stream. Hope you are good. I hope you enjoy the stream. So one of the first things that I would like to show you is one very necessary and crucial application that I believe anyone should have on his machine installed, and this is SnoopDos. SnoopDos is an application that can help you identify problems with applications. And what it does is whenever you try something to run on your AmigaOS, it logs all the steps that this application tries to access, all the files, all the resources. And if something fails, you have this indication in a list, so you can go and fix the problem or find a workaround of that. So for me, SnoopDos can be found for, you can find SnoopDos on Aminet. It's free, or it's freeware. And for me right now, I'm going to drag it in applications and open it, so to show you how it works. Okay. That's the SnoopDos, the main window. You can log to see how it works. You already have seen here that some things are starting appearing, but let's say that I want to open find. You will see all the libraries that it is opening and all the tool types that it's trying to access. And if you want to pause the logging, you can click here and pause. Or if you want to save the log into a file, you can go here and buffer, save buffer. And this is going to give you, for example, here in RAM, SnoopDos log. This will give you a text file with all the information. For example, if I go and open the text edit to try to open this this file, we can find it in RAM, SnoopDos log. Here, which is really necessary if you want to contact the developer of an application and he needs some more information on why his application is failing on your machine. It is a good idea always to use SnoopDos and find the failing parts, so that he is going to be able to identify the problem. For example, right now that imp doesn't work for me. I will try to figure out if there is a problem with my installation, but it seems it is not. Maybe imp developer is doing something on his server. That's why it is not working. I don't know, I'm going to investigate it more and see why this doesn't work. So SnoopDos is one of the best applications that you can have on your Amiga OS and really useful to figure out what is going wrong with an application or whatever you are trying to do. And this is going to be used later while we are going to try to bring some applications from AmigaOS 3.9 to AmigaOS 3.2. Right now, I would like to welcome Chandering, Four Fators, Retro Passion UK, SD Muke, and Vince QR to the stream. I hope you guys have fun, and we are going to see interesting things today. Before we continue, what I like to do on every stream is to discuss a little bit about the basic folders that AmigaOS has, so that we all can be familiar with the AmigaOS. And in previous streams, we discussed about all these folders that we see in our installation partition. And today I was thinking to discuss about some of the hidden folders, for example, fonts, C, libs. We can see all these folders today. For example, C. Good evening from Ireland, Retro Passion. Welcome to the stream. For example, C, it's a really crucial folder that has all the executables and commands of the Amiga OS. Here we can find commands like list or dir, which we use in our shell. Welcome, Prince Face. Welcome to the stream. For example, if we do here new cell and we type dir, this command comes from this folder C, and usually C is also has an assign like that, which we can visit it. And if we do a list, for example, here, it's the command, this command in this partition. Here you are going to find most of the commands of Amiga cell. So if you want to use others, for example, we installed LHA here just by copying the executable in C, and C also, the C folder is also a folder that is available wherever you are in the system, so you don't have to write C colon LHA just to execute that file. You just need to say LHA and it is going to work, even if you are on a totally different partition. If you say LHA, it is going to work, because C is added in an environment variable called path that has all the folders that the system goes and searches about an executable file. And this is set on a startup sequence, so if you want to add more paths there, you can do it. In previous stream, we talked about S a lot. Fonts is another necessary folder, because it keeps all the font files that can be used in the operating system in AmigaOS. And if you want to install a font that you want to use it globally on any application, you just need to copy it here. Another folder that we could check is libraries. This is also a really necessary folder because it keeps all the different libraries that the operating system is using and the applications are using. And here you can find all the libraries for commodities, for and also for Picasso, and all the necessary libraries for the operating system to work. Sometimes when you boot let's say application that boots from a floppy, you might not have a libraries folder, because that application might not use any of them. So it is not necessary that any application use these libraries. But for example, later we are going to see how to install UnArc. UnArc is using a library called xad, which is a library that has information on how to unarchive archives like LHA and other files, zip, for example. And all this and the installation of XAD library is done in this folder. So in case you want to change something or update something or delete it, you know where you are going to find it. And actually, I will say after that to move on to install XAD library, which is a necessary library. I will use the 0.20 version, because this machine, this emulated Amiga, is based on 0.20. If you have any question and if you want some more information, feel free to ask me at the chat, and I'm going to try to answer as good as I can. And for now, I'm going to de-archive the XAD master library. This library can also be, you can find this library also on Aminet. And this library on its own, it is not useful at all because it doesn't have any application that you can use. There are a couple of commands, if I'm not wrong. Let me have a look. Let's first install it. So you see, okay, the docs. So to install the docs, it asks where to install them. A good practice is to install the documentation of an application inside a folder that is called locale. And here you are going to find the help folder, and maybe inside the English you can install this documentation for this file. Or if you don't want, or if you don't want inside English, you can go to the parent and install it here. XPK master can be found in your essentials drawer or partition. Okay, great. And there is also a key available for this, which also you can find on AmiNet. Let me uninstall it, unarchive it. You see, it's just a file that usually we put in C, in S folder. So I'm going to copy it from RAM, xad master key to S. So it is going to be available for xad. If we go to C and do a dir right now, you are going to see a few commands here. Xad list, xad lib info. These commands can be used to dearchive some files. For example, if we do xad unfile and we see information about it, it requires the file name and the destination. And let's try to use it from the terminal. Let's say that we want to dearchive the Vincent. Okay, so if I go to Essentials and do an xad unfile, .98 LHA, and the destination okay, required argument is missing from. An error occurred. Okay, probably it needs a reset just to load the library, and we are going to test it again. One application that can be used with that uses XAD library is MUIUnArc. It is pretty much close to the UnArc that we know from AmigaOS 3.9, and but it uses a magic user interface. So I will say to go and download this one. and try to install it and see how it works on the AmigaOS. This application is useful because you don't have to use the terminal to de-archive any archive file. So it is more let's say easy to use, and everyone can use it. And if you add those files to the how it is called the you know that AmigaOS 3.2 has a way to understand which version, which file, which application should be used with its file type, for example, with default icons. So if you go to LHA and add that application as a default application to run, then when you double click on an LHA file, you can make it to run with MUIUnArc, and which we are going to see later in the stream. So MUIUnArc version 45.14, let's download it. Inside downloads. Okay. Let's keep this open in case we need to download something else. Internet downloads. Okay, it seems that this doesn't have any folder, so I'm going to go inside applications and create a new folder. Like that, and I'm going to copy both of these files inside the folder. Similar applications like MUIUnArc, there are plenty in AmiNet, but I like this one because it looks pretty close to UnArc that we had in AmigaOS 3.9. But feel free to send me on the chat which other application do you propose doing for this, doing the same work for you, and you would like to make it more to propose it to other people so they can use it as well. MUIUnArc requires XVS library, which is a library that has information about the various viruses. So let's download this as well. Okay. And new cell. If I'm doing the things really fast, please tell me to slow down, or explain to you what exactly I'm doing. Downloads, and let's say XVS library to RAM. So I de-archive this library into the RAM, and I'm going to go and install it as well. Okay, right now it says that it doesn't find a C installer in our machine. Usually installer, if I'm not wrong, this is the case here as well. Installer is inside utilities, but some people place installer in C. No, not in utilities, it is in tools. No. Okay. Where is it? Okay, it's time to use find. To use find here and search in sys, which is the boot partition, search for installer. Right now it's going to search in the partition that we booted our machine. For me is this system. Okay, installer is in system folder. So to overcome this problem, the only thing that we need to do is to open the information of this icon, go to the icon tab, and then remove the path and save it. This way it tries to find this installer in the environment, in all the paths that are available in the in your system. If we double click, it starts install. Okay, no, proceed. So if we go now into our system, show all the files and visit libs, in this folder we have XPS library and the xadmaster library that we installed earlier, with all the, and inside this folder has separated plugins for the xadmaster library, that those plugins describe the different archives and how this can be used for de-archiving the files. Okay, for example, you see LZX and others as well. RAR, which is pretty common. These files can be found, updated versions of these files can be found on Aminet as well. So if we try now to open MUIUnArc, okay, it asks for XFD master library. Let's see if we can find it inside Aminet. Okay, this is here. Okay, let's download it. Great. And while we download it, if you go here and say XAD and search about that on Aminet, I would like to show you that. Here is the xadmaster 020 that I downloaded to install the library. And those files are updated versions, xad underscore something, updated versions of the different plugins that xad has installed under libs that I showed you earlier, and you can download them to use them. Have in mind that some of them, like you can see here, these files are for AmigaOS 4 and they won't work on AmigaOS 3.2, of course. Okay, XFD library is downloaded, so let's dearchive that file, XFD master at RAM. Okay, and I hope that is going to be the last library that is needed. Install. Okay. Okay. XFD master is going to be found inside libs. Finally. So right now we have this application running, MUIUnArc. So if I'm going to find an archive, let's say Finset here, the LHA, you can drag and drop it inside the application, just like you do on UnArc that comes with AmigaOS 3.9. And let's say destination is RAM. Here, okay. UnArc, and this is going to be, to de-archive the file in RAM. Of course, you can add MUIUnArc on the menu that you have on AmigaOS 3.2, and whenever you want to use it like that, find it from the menu and open it. We can see that how you can do it. Any questions, guys? I just wanted to show you the MUIUnArc because it's a good alternative to the UnArc that most people are used to from AmigaOS 3.9. And it is available on AmiNet free of charge, so anyone can use it. Let me delete some things from the RAM. Okay. So now this is finished and we have the de-archived file here to use it if we want. And the good thing with this application it is that it can be used for many different types of archives. Okay, zip, rar, whatever you want. So if we would like to add it at the menu here, I don't know if you sorry, if you have seen one of my previous streams, we discussed about that a lot. And to add something here on the menu, inside this menu, for example, under Utils, you have to go to Workbench Startup. And back then we did create a my menu tools file, so I'm going to open that on with the text edit. And drag and drop it here. And let me maximize that. Okay. And we want to add it here in Utils. So what I'm going to do is take this line and copy it and paste it above like that. And sorry, and I'm going to add here a unique name that it needs, and that will be MUIUnArc. We can add this name here as well. That will be the label that will be shown at the menu. And the command that is going to run is, if you remember, we installed it inside application folder in our boot partition here. So I'm going to say, sorry, I'm going to say sys, which is my boot partition, applications. I'm giving the whole path where this can be found, unarc / MUIUnArc. Okay, and I'm going to save it. Great. So now if I double click on my here, these error messages are because we tried, by double clicking on this script, we tried to add three menu items that are already there, but we will see MUIUnArc already added. So if we click on that, it will start. Let's do a reboot. And I think it will be good to see how we can add MUIUnArc as a default application for all the LHA files, for example, so that you can do it with any other file type if you want, LZX or ZIP or anything. Let's check again the menu. You see, it's there. So whenever we want to run it, we just select it and runs. But it will be good if we could do, let's say we have here some LHA files. If I double click to open it with MUIUnArc, to do that, we can go to prefs and default icons, and here find the file type that we want, which is LHA, this one, LHA arc, and it says here icon doesn't exist, will show parent icon. So if we click here, we will see how default icons recognizes these files by if they contain these strings in specific places inside the file. Okay, so if we do change icon, it asks us if the file type, because it doesn't have an icon, the file type currently doesn't have an icon, what do you want to do? I will say copy from parent. So right now it is going to have an icon. Okay, cancel. And we need now to set the default default application. So what we need to set is, find here the MUIUnArc. Applications, MUIUnArc, the executable, here, and save it. Save. And let's see if that works. So by doing those two, three easy steps, you can set exactly an application, a specific file type to open with MUIUnArc by double clicking on that. And if we see right now the this folder in icons, you will see that those files have the icon that we set on the default icons application. And if you double click on anything, let's say this one, it's going to start the application with the contents and just drag and drop or not. Just cancel, yeah. Drag and drop here the destination, and you have the, let's say, the same way that we were using UnArc on AmigaOS 3.9. What do you think? It is pretty easy to set all these things up on your machine, even if these are not already done by the operating system when you installed it. We were used on these things back with AmigaOS 3.9, but I showed you that this is pretty easy to be done on AmigaOS 3.2 as well. And this is something that you have to do only once. And this is not necessarily something that you have to do all the time. And actually, if we go to, let's say, to find where exactly this icon was created, if you remember from previous streams, the default icons are stored inside Envark Sys folder. The Envark Sys folder is a folder that can be found inside the preferences folder. Here is Envark archive, environment archive, and if we open that, here is a folder named Sys. And this, in this folder, there are all the default icons. That's why it takes some time to open. That's the default archive icon, the parent icon that we saw on the default icons application, if you remember. If you remember, it was saying that, let me show you that again, with a different thing, with a different file type. If you remember, in default icons, every archive here doesn't have their own icon. They get the parent icon. For example, if I click change icon, it asks to get the parent icon. That parent icon is this, default archive. Okay, def archive. And that was copied when I said here, copy from parent. That was copied to LHAArc. Okay. So if you open right now here, if you go and do information, you will see the default icon, the default application that I set through the default icons application. It's exactly the same thing. So either you can go from default icons and do that setup as I showed you earlier, or you can come in the archive Envark folder here and change it. For example, if I would like to change the default source to use a different default application, I could open the information of that and change from text edit to something else. Okay, and that would work. That's the way that this def icons are working, and that's the way the AmigaOS is can recognize what which application is going to be used as a default application for any file type. I don't know how many of you are familiar with this concept, but it is really useful to know where and how you can change stuff like that on AmigaOS operating system. And that's something that is not only for AmigaOS 3.2, but for all the AmigaOS 3 series of the operating system. You are going to find it on 3.1, 3.5, 3.14, and 3.9 as well. Just with just different maybe applications like the default icons. For example, AmigaOS 3.9 has def icons, a different, totally different application. 3.1 doesn't have anything, and 3.1.4 also doesn't have something similar. And this default icons is a new, totally brand new application for AmigaOS 3.2. What do you think? Is it useful? Is it something that you would like to ask, so we can share it with the rest of the people in the chat? Any application different that you are using except MUIUnArc? Because a lot of people are used to UnArc from 3.9, I would like to show you how you can bring it to AmigaOS 3.2 and use it here as well. So for now, I'm going to quit the emulated Amiga so that I can mount the AmigaOS 3.9 ISO. And see how we can do it in AmigaOS 3.2. Remember that both AmigaOS 3.9 and 3.2 use Reaction for the different applications. And this is necessary for UnArc to work, and AmiDock, and all the applications, most applications from AmigaOS 3.9. So, possible we are going to run UnArc and do not start at all, but we are going to give it a try. This is the folder of AmigaOS 3.9, and instead of installing it, we are going to find where exactly is the application that we are looking for. Let's check here, Workbench 3.9. And if I remember correct, it should be inside tools here. Let me take it and copy it inside applications. And give it a try. The recommended process will be to install AmigaOS 3.9 to a different partition and apply there all the Boeing bugs. So if there is any update for UnArc, you are going to have the updated version. But for now, we are going to see it like that, just by copying that from the CD and try to run it. And as you can see, it requires resource library. Okay, resource library is a library that can be found in libs, I guess, because it has the extensions extension library. It should be here. If not, okay, it is not, cannot see it here. So find is going to be our it's going to help us find where exactly this resource library is. And that's why this application is so useful. And we are looking for resource.library. Okay, let's give it a few minutes. Or a few seconds, I hope. for this to find it. Are you, I guess that most of you have already AmigaOS 3.2 installed on your machines or not? Is anyone that haven't tried that yet? If you do, guys, please tell me so that we can discuss. So, yeah, it is in emergency boot libs. That's one place that this was found. Okay. Let me cancel it and search only inside OS 3 version. Okay. And here. Okay, it is somewhere there. Start. But either way, we found it inside the emergency boot, which is this one folder. Hello, Skynet 060. Welcome to the stream. We are looking right now how we can bring some applications from AmigaOS 3.9 to AmigaOS 3.2. And right now I'm trying to make an arc work. And it requires a library that is called resource.library. So I'm looking to find this library and copy it to the AmigaOS 3.2. I'm using the default font from AmigaOS 3.2. This is Topaz, if I'm not wrong. Let me show you font. Yes, Topaz 8. Is it clear on your screen? Do you think that is it difficult for you to read it? Do you think that it is needed to make it bigger? Ah, okay, that's great. So, in case Skynet, you missed it, earlier we installed a XAD library, XVS library, which are all needed for MUIUnArc to work. And we saw earlier on the stream that how you can add MUIUnArc here on the menu, so to start by selecting that from the menu, and also how you can set it as the default application for LHA files, which is the same process that you can do for any other archive. But now, just for the fun, we try to make an arc from AmigaOS 3.9 to work on our system. So since we found the library that we needed, we just need to copy it inside libs folder of our boot partition. That's the one. Copy it here and try again to run an arc, and it works simply by that. And if we try to de-archive something. Let's say this. It shows the files here. And if we drag and drop the destination, it seems to work just fine. Let me see. So an arc from AmigaOS 3.9 wanted only the resource dot library, but have in mind that we have reaction from AmigaOS 3.2 working on our machine. If we didn't, it would ask for various gadgets, classes, and things like that. And we also already installed the xadmaster library, which is crucial for an arc. So we didn't ask for these things because we already had them on our system. So if someone prefers to use UnArc, that's the way to make it work on your machine, on AmigaOS 3.2. But if you want something else from Aminet that uses a magic user interface, MUIUnArc is also a good alternative application, which if you want to use the XVS or XFD library, you have to just check them here. And whenever you try to de-archive something, this application is going to check it against this XVS library for viruses. So you can be more secure that the archive that you downloaded doesn't have any viruses in there. But if you're using something else as your daily de-archive application, feel free to share it on the chat and so that we can all be aware about this application. Let me fix a little bit the icons here. The range. And if you have any question, please feel free to tell me. I'm looking a little bit at the notes that I have here. Okay. Great. The next application that I would like to bring to AmigaOS 3.2 is AmiDock. So let me try to find it here. AmiDock. If I'm not wrong, AmiDock is inside Tools. Tools and commodities. No, Workbench startup. Yes, that's the version. Okay, and let's say that. For now, let's not put it on our Workbench startup, but let's put it inside applications. So to make sure that it's working fine. And as I said earlier, it is better to do it not straight from the CD-ROM, but from an installation, a separate installation that you have for AmigaOS 3.9. Just to have the Boeing bugs applied, the updates of the Boeing bugs applied. But because I don't have such an installation right now, I'm doing it from the CD-ROM. Let's double click on that. And we see that it doesn't work. How can we find what is going wrong? As we discussed earlier, SnoopDos is our friend in such situations. And let's try to run again AmiDock. And we see here that it tries to find the wizard library, but it can't find it. So we are going to find that library from AmigaOS 3.9 CD-ROM and copy it to AmigaOS 3.2. And because I don't want to get any output here, I press this button disable. Have in mind that if you have it enabled, the system slows down a little bit because it uses some resources to show things on the list and also to log all this information. I'm going here in AmigaOS 3.9 and I'm going to use find. Okay. and we are looking for wizard.library. And while it searches about it, let me open a cell. So to go to AmigaOS 3.9 emergency boot and libs and see if in any case it is there. Okay, we don't need anymore this search. Cancel it. Okay, we have wizard library inside this folder. I'm inside the emergency boot folder of AmigaOS 3.9. So I'm going to copy that to wizard library to libs. Libs is the assign to libs folder inside our boot partition, the one that we want to copy that to. So this is now copied. And it should be available for AmiDock to work. Let me try to open again AmiDock. And still doesn't work. Oh, now, here it is. It works. It works fine. Okay, let me close a little bit, a few things here. Let me close this. Great. So AmiDock needed a wizard library to work. So if I'm going to put it here, the UnArc, maybe iGame, like that, and set it to be horizontal, snap bottom left. I don't want any icon names. Flash, okay. Here it looks for some preset files that it can't find because we didn't copy them from the AmigaOS 3.9. We can do it if we want, and we can use it like in AmigaOS 3.9. Okay. Quit. And that's how AmiDock can be used from AmigaOS 3.9 to AmigaOS 3.2. As you can see, the process is pretty easy and straightforward for anyone to do. But if you have any questions, feel free to tell me while I'm trying to find the presets files. And also tell me if you have AmigaOS 3.2 and if you transferred anything from AmigaOS 3.9. I have seen a lot of videos on YouTube that a lot of people prefer to update their AmigaOS 3.9 to AmigaOS 3.2. And I don't know how that works because I never tried it. But tell me your opinion on that. Is it something that we should do, or it is better to set something from the scratch and transfer only the things that you care most? Preferences, if I'm not wrong, presets is here. Let's see if we can find the AmiDock ones. Let's copy them inside our presets. AmiDock. Okay, so if now we quit it and we reopen that, it opens with the default patterns on the background. Just exactly the way that it would work on AmigaOS 3.9. One thing that I would like also to bring from AmigaOS 3.9 is the PDF viewer. If I'm not wrong, it has a good PDF viewer, but this might be a little bit more tricky, but never done that. Let's do it together here. We have plenty of time. It should be inside tools or not. Or it was in contribution. No. No. I might be wrong also. Let me try to find it. I'm going to try to find anything that the file name contains PDF. Cancel PDF without the dot. Okay. So we have some glow icons. Let me see where these files are. Open drawer. Okay. Dev PDF. Okay. Let me cancel it. And the search is finished. Oh, okay. My bad, it seems that there is no PDF application. Okay. Of course, if you want AmiDock to start on every boot, the thing that you need to do is to go here and, oh no. Okay, and drag and drop it inside Workbench Startup, and also check the if it waits for any input from the user. This one here, so do not wait, prompt for input, start priority. Let's save it and reboot to see if it works at all on our machine. That's pretty much the things that I wanted to tell you and show you today. But what I wanted to also show you is the Xbench application and how, you see, it works just fine. the expense application that didn't work on my last stream last week, a week ago, and what exactly is the problem and how you can make it work on AmigaOS 3.2. If you remember, a week ago we discussed about how we can how we can have WSD load games on our machine, and we saw a few front-end application to use for starting these games. One of these front-end applications is Xbench, which didn't work with AmigaOS 3.2, and it was crashing all the time. And it seems it is the reason is that it is not compatible with AmigaOS 3.2, because when you try to when you run it, it tries to find some commands in C, and one of the commands that it requires is execute. If we go to the C folder and we do dir, you will see that execute is not here. Execute doesn't exist inside C. But if we do execute, for example, it complains that it doesn't have a specific argument. And if we do version execute, we see that it exists, but it exists inside shell. Execute is one of the commands that with AmigaOS 3.2, it is not anymore a file under C, but it is included inside shell. And while I was searching for a way to overcome that problem and make Xbench work, I discussed that with the developers of AmigaOS 3.2 at the beta testing mailing list, and they recommended to use the execute command that exists inside the install floppy of 3.2. So what we can do is let's mount this floppy and open again a shell and go to install 3.2, and if we do a dir, you see that there is a folder C. Let's go there, dir, and here it is, the command that we need. So we are going to copy that. Execute to C, so that we can have it available in our system. Now, if I go to Xbench and run it, and wait for a few seconds, you see that it uses my key for the Xbench. And now it works just fine. And it has some great music as well. So I also contacted the developer of Xbench, and he is going to work on a new version that is going to work just fine with the AmigaOS 3.2, so that anyone can use it without doing this trick to overcome the problem. And let me show you a little bit about the Xbench. First option here, Xbench, actually it's a program that you can put on your startup sequence, like the tiny launcher that we saw as well, and you can have it running while when your Amiga starts, and have it like a front end, of course. It's so Xbench has a few more things than Tiny Launcher, which is very useful. Here in launchers you can find the games that you want to run, or you may have any other application, any executable for AmigaOS, and we can see how you can set this up. Explorer is something like a file manager inside the Xbench. There is a file manager in case you want to, let's see that right now, in case you want to copy files from one folder to another. You have your mouse here, so you can select something, and let's say libs, in case you want to do some work copying games from a folder to another and things like that. And if you have the Xbench as your front end without even the need to open Workbench or whatever, you can copy them, delete files, create new folders, and also it is possible to create your own buttons here from the setup. And if you have a playlist of mods, to open them here, and while you are doing some work, listen to your music. If you want to get off that and return to the main page, to the main screen, then there is Cell that, let's see that. Cell is a full screen cell to do things. For example, go to C, do a D, whatever you will do on a cell window in your workbench. And if you want to exit from that, you can do end CLI and it exits. The colors of the cell, you saw that it is black background and green letters. But this can also change from here, the setup. But let's see how we can make our games, WSDLoad games, available for the Xbench. There are a lot of options here. For example, CLI, you can change the colors to whatever you want. For the Explorer, to set your commands if you want, but for the WSDLoad here, this option WSDLoad gives you the default to select the default options that you want every game to use when you launch them. For example, if you want to use the MMU or not, or if you want to do a preload. Okay, and from launchers you can set up to 6 lists. And you set here the type of the list. For example, it is WSDLoad, Excel files, manuals. It's readme text that can open and see information about a specific game. We select WSDLoad. We give it a name, games. For example, path. We select the path where we have the games. I have them here in games folder, and then we do update. You will see that it scans this folder and tries to find all the slave files for these games. Slave files are all WSDLoad games. Okay, it takes a few seconds to read my small collection of games here. But depending on the amount of the number of the games that you might have inside this inside your games folder, it might take a little bit longer. So this you see here these are launchers. You can set up different lists, and these are the launchers that you can use on the main screen. Let's see, 67%. Here it shows the amount of memory that you have available, cheap RAM and fast RAM. Okay, update OK, just added 15 files to list 1. Okay, let's exit. And here on setup, you can set if you want to have music or not, and other things. On startup, you can set what script will be running when you start the expense. Okay, exit setup. Of course, there are a lot of options there. It will be better to read the Amiga guide file that comes with the application and then see how you can set it up based on your requirements. Launchers. And here, logically, if everything goes well, it will show us the list of the games that we have. Let's try something to run something. This screen can be also used with your joystick, if you have a joystick on your Amiga. Let me start Canon Fighter 2. It says this screen is also from Xbench, that it tries to start the application. It shows the screen of the workbench with the pop-up of the WSD load, and the reason that it does that is because there is an update here, otherwise you wouldn't see something like that. Or in case there are some options, you might see also this pop-up. We start it and we start the game. Like every front-end for WSD load games. And if we want to exit, F10 exits from WSD load and shows again the list of the games to select something else. Say Hero Quest 2. And that's the Xbench, guys. Pretty good application. It's still on development, and I hope that soon we are going to have a fixed version that might have extra features. As you have seen, the screen that has the list of the games, it, at the bottom there is a box for screenshots. If I'm not wrong, I don't remember how this exactly is this exactly works, but I think that you can have the screenshots in one specific folder in your machine and then ask Xbench to load the screenshots from this folder. I don't know if you have any questions about Xbench. If you do, as you can see, every screen then randomly starts playing a different module, so that it is not boring to listen all the time on the same module as a background. That's all from me right now. I don't have any extra things in mind to show you. I don't know if you have any questions about what we saw today, and if you would like to discuss something about what we have seen. Xbench is a very good application which deserves to investigate and see if it covers your needs. And if you exit here, it returns to Workbench. And if you have that in your startup sequence loaded before the load Workbench, so and you reboot your machine, it starts, and if you click exit, it loads the Workbench just fine. That's all, guys, for me today. I hope that stream is useful, and you had the chance to learn something new, and had the chance to see how you can use your AmigaOS with this application that I showed you today, about utilities that you can use every day to de-archive your archived files, your LHA files, LZX or ZIP, and how you can bring things from AmigaOS 3.9 to 3.2, and also if there is a problem with something that doesn't work well, how you can use SnoopDos to figure out what exactly is the problem and try to solve it yourself, or give some extra information to the developer or the team that maintains this project, so they can figure out what the problem is and propose a solution. I hope you find this stream useful. I stream every Friday at 7:30 in the evening CET, and hope to see you in the next stream as well. And guys, share with your friends about the stream so that they will be able to come here and discuss with all of us things that we would like to do and learn on AmigaOS. This video is going also to be uploaded on YouTube, where I have all the previous streams on my channel on YouTube, where you can find all the previous streams and see what we discussed there and useful tips for AmigaOS 3.2. Hope to see you again next Friday. Take care and have fun with your AmigaOS. Bye-bye.